Today topic is particle in a box, or sometimes this is called a particle in an infinite potential well. This is an application of this Schrödinger equation, where a particle is trapped in a potential well. The idea is we have this one-dimensional potential well. This is our x-axis. Dimension of this well, x is equal to 0 to x is equal to capital L, where V is infinite at x is equal to 0 and at x is equal to L. This is our particle inside this well. So we have to use here the time independent Schrödinger equation, because potential is equal to 0 inside the well. It means this particle is not bound, it is free to move here and there. So to find the eigenstates, eigenfunction of this particle and the eigenvalues of these, using the Schrödinger equation, that is the time independent Schrödinger equation, we have to use. So time independent Schrödinger equation, I have to use to calculate the eigenfunctions and eigenvalues, that is d2 psi upon dx square plus 2m upon h cross square e minus v psi is equal to 0. This is our first equation, and this is time independent. A time independent Schrödinger equation means potential is independent from the time. So there is no function of the time related to the potential. So we have assumed here V is equal to 0. That means particle is free. Free particle. There is no boundation on the particle. But to find the all eigenfunctions related to this particle, which is free to move here and there in this well, so I am using this boundary condition, that because this particle we can observe within this dimension, so psi x, that is the wave function associated with this particle, is equal to 0. Why it is 0? Because this particle cannot be found at x is equal to 0 and at x is equal to L. The probability of finding this particle only within the dimension of this potential well. So psi x is the wave function that is related to this particle, is equal to 0 at x is equal to 0. So you cannot find out this particle at this position at x is equal to 0. And similarly for x is equal to L. These two are boundary conditions where the wave function is equal to 0. Or you can say that the probability of this particle at these points is equal to 0. So when I am putting the value V is equal to 0 in this Schrödinger equation, which is time independent, that means potential energy is not a function of time, then this equation becomes d2 psi upon dx square plus 2m h cross square v is equal to 0 and this e psi is equal to 0. This is second order differential equation of this wave function. So I can assume that this 2m e h cross square is equal to k square. So this is I am assuming that k square is equal to 2me upon h cross square, where k is the wave vector. So this equation becomes d2 psi upon dx square plus k square psi is equal to 0. This is equation number 2. So this Schrodinger equations becomes in this form, which is a second order differential equation, and one can find out the solution of this equation. So by solving this equation, we can find out the eigenfunctions, or you can say wave function associated with this particle. Now the solution of this equation is psi is equal to, I have this equation d2 psi dx square plus k square psi is equal to 0. The solution of this second order differential equation will be psi is equal to, psi is a function of only x, that is equal to a sin kx plus b cos kx. This is equation number 3, where a and b are, these a and b are arbitrary constants. These are constants, and we have to find out the value of these constant using this boundary condition. Now our wave function is equal to 0, this psi x is equal to 0 when x is equal to 0 and at x is equal to L also. So I am putting this value using this boundary condition at x is equal to 0. We know psi x is equal to 0, it means this psi x is equal to 0 a sin 0 plus b cos 0. The sum of these two terms is equal to 0. Here sin 0 is equal to 0. That means a is not equal to 0. Cos 0 is equal to 1. So it means b is equal to 0. So one can conclude here that the constant b is equal to 0. So now for this x is equal to L, this wave function, this is our first boundary condition, and second boundary condition, that is at x is equal to L, and again this wave function is equal to 0. So putting this value in the equation number 3, we get psi x is equal to 0 a sin k l, where x is equal to l, and plus b cos k x. Now b is equal to 0, and this cos k l. So this is understood that this term is equal to 0, and I have only this one, a sin kl. So a sin kl is equal to 0, and from this relation we know that a could not be 0. So I have sin kl is equal to 0. So it means this condition will satisfy only when this kl will be equal to n pi. So I am using this relation. The sine kl is equal to 0. Sine kl is equal to 0. This condition will satisfy only when this kl is equal to n pi. For a given value of n, 1, 2, 3 and so on, sine n pi will be equal to 0. So kl is equal to n pi, and I can conclude that value of k will be equal to n pi upon l. So this is the value of wave vector, where n is the number of the state, pi is a constant, l is the dimension of the wave. This is l. Now I have to put this value of k in the formula which I have used here in equation number 2. K square is equal to 2me upon h cross square. So I have to find out the value of e in terms of this k. That becomes 2me upon h cross square. And now I have to put this value again in here. So it is equal to n square pi square upon l square. So E is equal to n square pi square h cross square upon 2m l square. So this is the energy value for this particle. Now to make simplify it, we know h bar is equal to h upon 2 pi. So putting this value here, this becomes n square pi square h square upon 4 pi square, and 4 into 2, 8 pi square into this m and l square. Pi square cancel out, and we have only this n square h square upon 8m l square. This is the energy eigenvalue for n state n. N is equal to 1, 2, 3 and so on. So this En is equal to n square h square upon 8m l square. This energy is directly proportional to the square of n and inversely proportional to the square of l, where h and m, these are constant. So I am writing this formula here for the energy. En is equal to n square h square upon 8m l square. So I can find out the eigenvalue of the particle, free particle, that is electron right now in our case, in any state, correspond to n is equal to 1, n is equal to 2, n is equal to 3 and so on. And these are for n is equal to 1. N is equal to 1, this E1 is equal to 1 H square upon 8 M L square. N is equal to 2, this is equal to E2, is equal to 4 H square upon 8 M L square. When N is equal to 3, for the third state, that becomes 9 H square upon 8m l square. So this time this is 4 times of E1. Here 9 times of E1. So ratio between these E1, E2, E3 and so on is 1, 4, 9, 16, like this one. So 1, 4, 9. This is the ratio between these energy level E1, E2, E3. And one thing which one can notice that these energies values are like this one. If this is E1, this is E2, this is E3. The energy gap between these levels are not uniform, and the values are different. So these are discrete energy levels, basically, which you can say that these energy levels are quantized. Discrete energy levels are quantized. So now the next point is related to the wave function. We have find out the value of this k, that is n pi upon l. Now putting this value in the wave function of the particle that we have defined in terms of a constant, this psi, which is a function of x, is equal to a sine kx. Now I'm putting the value of k here, so it becomes a sine n pi x upon n. This wave function is not normalized. What is the meaning of normalization? Because this a is equivalent to the amplitude of the wave. In simple harmonic motion, we define the displacement y is equal to a sine omega t plus kx, or if I write in terms of exponential term, this becomes y is equal to a e iota omega t minus kx. So here, when I compare this wave function with this simple displacement of a particle in terms of the wave, this a is equivalent to the amplitude. So right now I am saying that this wave function is not normalized, so I have to make it normalized. What is the condition of normalization? Normalization condition is minus infinity to plus infinity, the integration limit, and mod of psi square, that is wave function. I have considered here one dimensional situation, so I am writing dx. It should be equal to 1. If the wave function satisfies this condition, then the wave function will be normalized. So with a simple example, you can see that a wave function is shown by this way. Suppose this is psi 1 and this is picture A. The other example of the wave function is like this, and there is no small part of this wave function outside the well. So there are, this is psi 1, one example, this is also psi 1, another example. So in both the cases you can say that this picture is right without knowing more about the normalization condition. So this wave function actually does not provide complete information about the system. This wave function is not normalized within the boundary, but this wave function is normalized within the boundary of the system. So the purpose of normalization for any wave function is to bound that system within the boundary. And here our boundaries are start from x is equal to 0 to x is equal to n. It means I have to write these limits, x is equal to 0 to x is equal to n. So I have to integrate this integration within the limit of 0 to n. Then I will find out the value of this normalization constant. This A is known as normalization constant, and this condition is known as normalization condition. So when I put this value of psi x in this equation, So I found the result for normalization constant A, that is equal to under root 2 upon L. Directly I am writing this value here. You can solve this integration by putting these values Ix, that becomes A square sin square kx dx is equal to 1 within the limit of 0 to L. So you can simplify this integration by making using that cos 2x formula, and you will get this result, A is equal to square root 2 by L. Now I am putting this value of A, that is a normalization constant, in the wave function psi x. So psi x is equal to square root 2 upon L sine n pi x upon n. So this is normalized wave function for n state. N is equal to 1, you can write it for 1, psi 1, psi 2 and psi 3. So now we have the eigenvalue of the particle for different energy states and the eigenfunction, which is now normalized wave function. So if I have to find out the probability of any particle, I can use this normalized wave function, because without normalized function you cannot find out the probability distribution of the particle inside the potential well or the box. So this is our psi nx under root 2 upon L sine n pi x upon L. This is normalized wave function. What is the probability distribution? Probability we can define between the limits x1 is equal to 0 for an example, and this is x2. So probability within the dimension from x1 to x2 can be represented by this, is equal to mod of psi square dx within the limit of x1 to x2. So I can find out the probability of the particle within this dimension if my wave function is not, if my wave function is normalized. But if this wave function is not normalized, we cannot find out exactly the probability distribution of this particle within this box. So this is the formula of probability distribution. Now next point is, after discussing discussion about the wave function, energy eigenvalue, one more thing that is related to the wavelength. The wavelength we define with this distance. This is wavelength in simple, in a very simple language. We define this trough and crest is equal to lambda, that is wavelength of a simple harmonic motion. So lambda, this is our lambda. We know this is a microscopic system, a de Broglie wave is associated with this particle, that can be defined by lambda is equal to h upon p, where p is the momentum of this particle, lambda is the wavelength. So if suppose I have to find out the wave function of, if suppose I have to find out the momentum of this particle in different energy states. So I have to find out the momentum of this particle in energy E1 state, energy state E2, energy state E3. What will be the momentum of this particle? Because I know this is the lowest energy level, and this is first excited state, this is second excited state. It means these, if I am increasing above side, so this is the higher energy level as compared to this one. So E3 is at higher energy as compared to the E1 and E2. So all the electrons which exist in higher energy levels, their energy automatically will be higher as compared to the lower state. So the moment, obviously the momentum of the particle will be higher. So now my purpose is to find the momentum of those particles, or in this particular situation for this particle. So what will be the momentum of the particle? Because I know the potential is equal to zero within the well, so that particle will have only the kinetic energy. So I have defined already this total energy. So this total energy is the sum of kinetic energy and potential energy. But potential energy is equal to zero, so the particles will have only the kinetic energy. So kinetic energy of any particle we can define with this formula, P square upon 2m, which is 1 by 2 m v square. Basically this is our kinetic energy. So this kinetic energy is equal to this total energy of the particle. Why? Because potential is equal to zero, that particle have only kinetic energy, and that is equal to the total energy. So I am putting this value equal to this one. So n square h square upon 8 m l square is equal to this p square upon 2m. And further, I can put this value of P from here, that is equal to H upon lambda. P is equal to H upon lambda, that coming from the de Broglie wavelength concept. So P square is equal to H square upon lambda square. This is H square upon lambda square into 2m. Now simplify it, this term and this term. So H square cancel out, M cancel out, and this 2 is 4. So I have this N square, 4 L square. This is N square, 4 L square is equal to 1 upon lambda square here. So this can be written further. Lambda square is equal to 4 L square upon N square, or you can write this lambda is equal to 2 L upon N. So from here I can conclude that lambda is equal to 2L upon N. So I have only these variables L and these states. There are number of states. So N is equal to 1 correspond to the ground state. N is equal to 2 is the first excited state. Remember this point. When you use E2, that will be the first excited state. This E2 is the first excited state. This one, E1, is the ground state. So now I have find out that lambda is equal to 2L upon N, where L is the dimension of the well and N are the number of state. For N is equal to 1, lambda is equal to 2L. N is equal to 2, for this state lambda will be equal to L, and when N is equal to 3, for this state the lambda, the de Broglie wavelength which is associated with this particle, will be equal to 2L upon 3. So I have already defined that wavelength concept. This is the wavelength. Now N is equal to 1, when I am considering n is equal to 1, that time lambda is equal to 2L. This is lambda and it should be equal to the 2L, but we have only L. So I have this. For n is equal to 1, n is equal to 2, lambda is equal to L, that is this one. Now this is the total wavelength and this is equal to L. For n is equal to 2, n is equal to 3, lambda is equal to 2L upon 3, that means this is lambda L and this is again L by 3. So you can see here this point and this point, L by 3 plus L by 3 plus L by 3. Here L by 2, L by 2. This is L by. So these are basically the waveform of the wave function. On the other hand, so by using the de Broglie wave concept, we can define the wavelength associated with this ground state, first excited state, second excited state, and so on. Now this was the idea related to the wavelength of the matter wave associated with this free particle. Now suppose I have to find out the momentum of this particle in this energy state, or in this energy state, or in this particular energy state. So as I have mentioned already, that En, that is equal to n square h square upon 8ml square is equal to p square upon 2m. So this p square will be equal to m, cancel out 2, 4, this becomes n square h square upon 4 l square. So p is equal to n h upon 2 l. So if I have to find out the momentum of the particle, of this free particle, correspond to this state, then it will be P1. So P1 is equal to H upon 2L. N is equal to 1, that ground state, and H is Planck constant, 2L, L is the dimension. So momentum of this particle, free particle, in this state will be equal to H upon 2L. Momentum of this particle in second state will be correspond n is equal to 2 h upon 2l, and 2 cancel out, so p2 is equal to h upon l. And similarly for the third, n is equal to 3, so 3 by 2 h upon l will be p3. So by this way one can find out the momentum of the particle in different energy states. So this free particle in a potential box, through this we have seen both the ideas, the application of the Schrodinger equation and the idea of the Broglie wavelength. So by using this concept we make all these picture clear. So this free particle in terms of energy state E1, E2, E3, these are discrete, that means energy states are quantized. This is the normalized wave function by which one can find out the probability of the particle and the wavelength associated with this particle in different energy states, momentum of this particle in correspond to 1, 2 and 3. So this was the idea. Thank you.